We are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy.
Love me. Conspiracy.
Let's do this. Hey, welcome to Conspiracy Dummy, the conspiracy podcast that stands up when it pees. I am your host, the real most interesting man in the fucking world, Double D. Joining me on the podcast, we have the master of the universe, He-Man. What's good, homie?
Okay.
Or I should say Adam. Adam, what's good? That's He-Man's name, right? What's good, Adam?
Yeah.
Hey.
Apocalypse Adam, baby.
Yeah.
That's Adrian fine. She-Man.
I'm warming us up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And Alan, talk loud and clear from the gut. Man up.
Or just talk really distorted.
Or if you want to talk deep. Like talk manly then. Yeah.
Right.
If you could do that, that's even better.
Oh, if you can talk like a robot, so it just sounds kind of automated.
No, manly, just manly, oh, deep,
okay.
Deep in the gut.
Okay.
Yeah, talk like Barry White and his bitch, all right? Next, we have...
Oh, hey, do you know, can you do any kind of accent, Alan? Why don't you just go with an accent?
It's because he's He-Man. He's all that is man. He's like the voice of God. He's like the embodiment, like the voice of a manly man right now.
He's the alpha male?
Yeah, he's the fucking alpha male.
It would be American, okay. So we'll give him that.
All right, next, we have... The macho man of all macho men, the savage, Adrian. What's good, homie?
America.
Fuck yeah, America.
Fuck yeah.
Step into a Slim Jim. Oh yeah.
All right. Last but not least, we have the man that put Chuck Norris to shame, Mr. Williams. What's good, my homie?
Hello.
Yeah. So what's good, man? Thank you guys for joining on the podcast today. Today is a serious, serious topic, bro. We have a serious problem on our hands, or should I say our balls.
Mm.
Damn, guys. First, let me ask you guys, what is a man? I'll start with you, Mr. Williams.
I mean, biologically speaking, I would say a dude with a fat-ass hog, you know? Somebody that can fucking bench press a shitload. Somebody that makes more money than, you know, anybody else.
Yeah.
Somebody that has a leg up on society.
The third leg up on society.
The third leg on society, yes, sir.
Let me see. What's your thoughts, man? You guys agree with that?
Yeah.
Talk that shit, guys. Come on.
Yeah. Forgot to mention motorcycles.
Motorcycles.
Trucks.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Gotta throw in some beer.
Ooh. Yeah, keep them going. What else?
Heroin.
Oh shit. Maybe for some men, but not
that's
all.
That's all I got.
Yeah.
Oh.
Some hot ladies.
Mm.
All right. Well, anyways, guys, Nicole, the meaning for today is that I want to tell you guys, man, there's something going on, bro. Someone is trying to steal our mojo.
Yeah, baby.
They're trying to sterilize men, bro. They're trying to shrink our gooches and shit. Fucking, I don't know, our dicks probably. I don't know, man. Watch out. Watch your dicks. Man, look out for other people's dicks.
Measure that shit every day. You want to keep a log.
Yeah, man.
Make sure it's not shrinking in real time.
This shit's going down, bro. It's like a spermageddon, bro. They're trying to emasculate men everywhere, bro. So they won't be any alphas anymore, bro. They're trying to rid all alphas.
Fucking haters, dude.
Man, we can't have a world full of betas and shit. Fuck that.
I keep running out of room to put my balls.
Yeah, you tell them. That's right. Shit, man. So what's up, man? What do you guys think about this shit? Who's doing this, man? You think it's the Illuminati, the elite Illuminati, or you think it's the elite Illuminati's wives and shit. The Stepford wives? Shit.
What you want to go for America.
Who do you think is doing this shit, man? And why?
Who knows? Could be Hillary.
Good one, good one.
Could be Bill Gates.
Could start with Hillary.
Yeah, yeah. Good, good answers, guys. Good answers.
Bill, no condom Gates.
Yeah, I don't know, man. All the above, shit. Yeah, man, because there's new studies showing, bro, that they say the sperm count of men is down like 60% since the 1970s, bro. And that a huge testosterone decline in men has fallen, and, you know, in some cases, probably a rise in women and shit. You know what I mean? Fuck, what's going on here, bro? They also say that 30%.
But not me.
Yeah, yeah, you tell him, He-Man, you tell him. And 30% decline in 40-year-old men, bro. So, like, I don't know, man. What do you think? They're saying it could be phthalates, bro, and the fucking the personal care products that people use, you know, like soap, shampoos, fucking lubricants, you name it, bro. It's in toys, clothing, beverages, food, these little fucking microplastics or something. Or I think it's a chemical that makes plastic durable.
I think it's dick lasers.
Oh, shit, for real?
Think about that, bro.
That sounds like a bunch of things intended for women.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
You get that?
For women.
For women. Yeah, yeah, you're right. I agree. I agree, man. Sounds like that. Who? Let's all bang our chests, man. But yeah, man, let's see. Yeah, man. So I don't know. They say, like, this. I think there's this one doctor, too. What's her name? Shannon Swan. She's been going around talking about that, you know, our gooches, our taints, man, they're shrinking due to plastics and shit. Sooner or later, man, you're
not mine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not He-Man's, I forgot. But the gooch, like, you know, the balls and your asshole is, like, shrinking. It's pretty soon it's going to be, like, joint as one, bro.
Damn.
What the fuck's going to happen when that shit happens? Damn.
Not mine.
Well, none of ours. None of ours, bro. That's right. None of ours. But studies are showing that this shit's happening, bro. Not all over the world.
Does that mean I'm going to, like, poop on my sack more? Like, as I get older? I'm confused.
That may be.
That's going to suck.
Maybe, bro.
Can you imagine being at that point? And, like, every time you shit a little bit on the back of your balls. Like, you got to wipe that off, too.
Yeah, and you know when you start wiping your ass, you're going to get some on your balls now, for sure.
Oh, 100%.
It was always risky before.
I mean,
what's up?
I don't think it was happening in real time. I think it's like your kid gets a little closer and then their kid gets a little closer.
Well, speak for yourself. I mean, maybe not for you, He-Man, but
I don't know about you guys, but I got a 3-inch taint. You guys can't say that.
What is that, Macho Man? What are you saying?
You got a 3-inch.
I got a 3-inch. 3.5-inch taint.
Oh yeah, brother.
Exactly. That's just like, I don't know. I don't want to be bragging and everything. You know, but you gotta,
when I figure out how to measure mine, I'll let you know.
Shit, I measure mine with a fucking a midget. I just put it up against a midget.
I made my maids measure it the other night.
That's right. That's right.
I go by quarter baby carrot increments.
I measured your maid.
With my dick. All right. Hey, so yeah, man.
I measure my balls by the maid.
Yeah. So I don't know, man. She's saying that not just in humans, but it's happening in all mammals and shit. I guess I don't know how they're studying that shit. It's a long study, too, bro, that's been going on. I don't know. That's crazy. Just imagine that shit, just measuring chimps and whatever, you name it, what kind of mammals, humans, too, just measuring their taints over the years and just seeing them, like, slowly decrease and shrink. That's crazy.
Damn, dude. I wonder if that'd be a good job. I wonder if you need, a high school or, degree.
Imagine that on your resume.
Oh, dude. Bro, I've been the leading taint analyzer for the Tri-County, North Texas area. I've measured over 15,000 taints and just my first 10 years alone, dude.
And counting, bro.
And counting.
And counting.
Counting.
Damn, bro. It's going to be in the Guinness Book Records someday. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. You're going to be in there, man.
I appreciate the vote of confidence.
Oh, yeah. But shit, man. I don't know, man. That's crazy, bro. It's our balls are shrinking, supposedly. Not mine. Not definitely not He-Man's. Yeah. But what's up?
Your taint is where, if you were a female, your vagina hole would form.
Yeah.
So when you're born, you have like a vagina hole too?
Your balls are basically like the vagina lift, is how I've been told.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Dang.
Huh.
Like vagina lips are the balls of the body?
It's like the meat curtains.
Yeah, like, your soul. It's going to grow into one or the other. Like, that's what ours makes. Mm. So girls get the, yeah.
It makes sense. Makes sense why they look the same.
Yeah, bro.
Just like your penis is actually just a small female clitoris.
That's what they say when you're born, right? When you're in the womb and shit. Like doing, I guess, with the mother's testosterone level.
Mm-hmm.
If your fucking thing would drop, bro, your little clit would drop. You get a dick.
Mm.
Your little ovaries drop. You get little some balls and shit. They don't fully drop. Maybe until like you're, I don't know what age, but.
I don't know what you're talking about. I always have mine. Ridiculous.
Yeah, so shit. I don't know, man. It's crazy, bro. I'm telling you, bro. Watch out for your dick. Watch out for your balls. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, shit, man. Breaking news, bro. Hey, breaking news. A fucking new study. A new meta-analysis from Stanford University has concluded that the average penile length has increased by 24% for the past 29 years, bro. What the fuck?
That was 50% because of me.
Dude, that's cool, bro. So we're getting bigger dicks, but our gooches are shrinking. That's a fair trade, I say.
That is fair.
That is fair, I think.
I mean, shit, what would you take?
I maxed out my stat.
Would you take a
big in all areas, baby?
A bigger dick, like smaller balls, or bigger balls and a littler dick?
Big balls, big pain for a big point.
Dang,
bro. What would you get with, bro?
Dude, how long is your, like, what's your taint size?
Oh, shit. I don't know. I gotta find out, bro. That's good to know. I think every man knows their dick size, but the taint size, that's a new one, bro.
That's one we gotta figure out.
If I could get underneath my balls to find out, I'd let you know.
All right. Hey, shit, I was gonna say something fucking clever, but I forgot. Fuck. All my fucking blood is flowing to my balls right now, bro. I can't think right now and shit. All this fucking testosterone, all this manly talk, bro. It's fucking, that's what's up.
Well, at least dicks are getting bigger. I mean, over the past whatever year, 24 inches or some shit.
That's what's up.
I'll take it. But that's what happened to, like, some kind of monkey or some shit. I mean, like, their dicks got bigger, but their balls got smaller. It's like the reason why their dicks got bigger is because their balls were getting smaller, and they were having a harder time. The sperm was having a harder time making it all the way to the egg because they were, like, getting weak. So evolution's, like, response to that was like, oh shit, well, let's make the dick longer so that way the sperm doesn't have to travel as far.
Oh shit. Isn't it crazy too, bro, that we're all winners, bro?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Like, we're all fucking winners, bro.
Isn't this crazy? And I don't know about He-Man, but what's the average, like, what's the average specimen size in an average load? What, like 60 million, 80 million, 180 million?
And I think it's like 80.
In my case, one.
You just need that one, bro.
You just need the one.
It's the Neo, bro. He's like doing the Matrix moves and shit as he's getting closer to the fucking egg and shit. That's what's up, bro. It's all glitching and shit on the way.
Well, I think, what if all sperm is you, though? You know what I'm saying?
Like, all you?
Like, all like the
different
sperm.
Versions, like Kang and shit, the Conqueror? Like, they're all just different versions of you and shit?
I mean, it could be. But, like, what if... Yeah, who knows? What if every batch is, like, the same? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, like think of a batch of cookies. Like, they all taste pretty much the same. Yeah. Some might have a little bit here. Some might be a little different there.
Yeah.
But who knows? Every batch could be different.
Could be. You know, then whatever, who knows what's in that primordial soup of man, you know what I mean? Man, bro, that's what I'm saying. It's that sap of life, bro. Shit, we got that good. Man, I don't know, man, that's kind of crazy. We need a fucking, I don't know, man. It's something's up, bro. We need to stand together, bro. I'm telling you.
Dude, I could get a batch right now and go sell it for money. That's how much my shit's worth.
Dude, hell yeah, bro. Shit's like gold nowadays and shit.
It's the new gold rush.
For real. And also, man, we need fucking, like, we need more men out there, bro. Like, hoorahing and shit. Like I don't know, man. Representing and shit. You know what I mean? I don't know. They took out our homie Andrew Tate. He's over there locked up and shit.
Free top G.
Yeah, man. What the fuck?
How dare you?
Shit, bro.
I think it's, I don't know.
I don't know.
It's fucked up. It's fucked up what they're doing to men.
It is, bro.
The emasculation, the constant inoculations, yeah. You know, the degradation.
Yeah. It's crazy, bro. Shit's.
If anything, I feel like they're trying to blow alpha males away, get them out of the existence.
Yeah.
Fucking haters, dude.
For reals. That's what I'm telling you guys. You gotta bust nuts till you can't bust nuts no more, bro. Shit. Mm. Balls to the wall. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Bust out with your super sperm, bro. Where are them capes at? Yeah, man, because there's a fucking gap. There's a gap coming, bro. Slowly but surely, there's a gap coming. It's showing. There's a study showing, bro. I think there's a book out there called Boys and Man or some bullshit like that. I don't know.
Oh, from boys to men?
Yeah, from boys to men, yeah. They're talking about, like, how there's going to be a gap within men and women in the future, bro. Because most older men, mm-hmm. they want to date. Let's be real, bro. If you got money, you got some good money, bro. You're successful, wealthy and shit. Still got your good looking and shit. You know what I mean? You're going to want to go for some little younger honeys, bro. You know what I mean? It's like that Chris Rock bit. I don't know if you've seen his new special. I'm going to butcher it, but it's basically him talking about just get with the girl that's like in her 20s and some shit that's willing to just buy like dresses and shoes and whatever. Not, you know what I mean? Because it's a win-win situation. You're buying them clothes to look good, and I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't go there. Never mind. But I'm thirsty. Hold on.
Well, what's he saying, bro?
Basically, like, you know, if you date younger women, you know what I mean? Really, they just want to look good. Buy them some high heels. Buy them some dresses and shit. And it's a win-win situation. You know what I mean? They look good and they feel good. And then you're with them and shit. You know what I mean? You're benefiting, I guess. Get with older women, I guess, if you're that age.
What does 50s, an older woman have to
45,
offer?
45, 50. That's it. Well, I don't know. What do they have to offer? But maybe just like, hey, it's a difference, bro. A woman in their 20s asking you to buy them shoes than a woman in their 50s asking you to buy them fucking a house or fix their cars or fix their roof on their house or some shit, right?
Well, it's way more expensive.
Way more expensive. And I understand, like, these Leonardo's, DiCaprio's, these fucking George Clooney's, these motherfuckers, whoever, you name it, man. Why they don't want to settle down and shit.
It just all depends on whether or not they have a good meatloaf.
That's true.
Right.
You gotta give them the meatloaf.
But I'm not. It's nice you have two master's degrees, but how's that meatloaf? Exactly
what they said. What He-Man and Macho Man, the Savage said. Yeah, man. So you got like a gap within, like, so older men tend to like younger women. Mm-hmm. And younger women are starting to go for a man that's mostly stable, so they tend to go for older men. Then you have women mid, like in their 40s, 50s and shit, that can't really get with men their age, because men their age want to get with younger women, are now seeking out younger men and shit, right?
Gang.
There's a gap right there. And it's going to get even bigger and shit. There's going to be a big fucking, what you want to call it? Gaping hole.
Now, can we go back to the gaping hole?
The gaping hole? Yeah, and then women in college, bro, they're getting their degrees and shit. And studies are showing that men are dropping out of college at a 30% rate, and women are getting their degrees more than men are. And that's just going to fuck shit up. And now women just want to date men that have degrees. Imagine I got so stoned from there.
Now women want to take our jobs too?
So there's going to be a gap right there.
Listen, man, I'll be honest.
Yeah.
If, you know, I'm really tired of seeing on the news another story about how a female teacher slept with one of the male students, and there's all these, you know, repercussions and everything like that, especially towards the student, you know.
Yeah.
I feel like if a young man is able to accomplish that, which is, you know, mostly every young man's dream,
okay,
I think we should, you know, award that young man with something.
Shout out. Whether, pat on the back.
Whether it's a degree, you know, a house, you know, a nice index fund.
Like an award, a gold star.
Some, you know, we could erect a statue.
Yeah,
something. At the town library, something.
Yeah, I agree. What do you guys think about this? Macho Man, what do you think, man?
We need to have more hot teachers. I say you give him a notepad so he can write down that number of that teacher.
Yeah.
We
may even allow them girls come in even if they don't have degrees anymore. We just need more hot teachers.
Yeah. More hot teachers. I agree with more hot teachers.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yes. Oh, got it bad. Got it
bad. Got it bad. I'm hot for teacher. Gotta think of some kind of way. I've got it bad,
so bad. All right. Let's see. I'm hot for teacher. Shit, what else is going on in the news, man? Let's talk about some other shit. But yeah, that is warning, bro. You guys gotta keep a lookout for that shit, man.
Fuck Mary Kill. Drew Barrymore. Michelle Obama. Hillary Clinton.
Kill Hillary. Fuck Michelle. What was the first one again?
Drew Barrymore.
Oh, marry Drew Barrymore.
Sorry for me.
Is that... Oh, no. Maybe... Nah, maybe marry Michelle. Bang.
I do the same thing, but I leave Michelle out of it. Cause that's the man.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. You know what? Let's do this, man. Let's test our might, bro. Let's test our manhood, bro. Who's hotter? Alyssa Milano, Phoebe Cates, or Christina Applegate?
I only know one of those people, the first person.
Oh, that's right, huh? Just a generation.
Sound like the name of the cereal.
These are all like 80s shits. Yeah, Alyssa Milano, Who's the Boss? Phoebe Cates comes on. Okay, we got to scratch that one of shit.
Alyssa Milano sucks.
Yeah. Phoebe Cates is pretty hot when she came out of the pool. And Christina Applegate, bro, and Married with Children. She's the daughter and Married with Children.
I don't know. I didn't really like that show.
What? Al Bundy? Dude, the guy's a legend, bro. He scored like 4 touchdowns in a single game. And he's the leader of the No Ma'am, the National Organization of Men Against Amazonian Motherhood.
Oh, yeah.
Some deep shit, bro.
No, man.
No, we need a fucking...
It's not even a club if I'm not part of it.
No, dude. It's some secret society, bro. We need to bring it back. All right, let me see. What else?
Make secret societies great again.
Yeah, make secret societies great again, for sure.
Next question.
Next question. Okay. What's the hardest song?
Next question.
What's the hardest song for a man, bro? Is it Rocky's song, Eye of the Tiger by Survivor? Top Gun song, Danger Zone. Or Hulk Hogan song, Real American.
Fight for the rights of every man.
I'm gonna go take a piss outside.
Yeah. You go pee.
Fight for what's right. Fight for your life.
What's the most manly song?
Is this a trick question?
It could be. What do you think is the most manly song out of those
John
three?
Cena theme song?
John Cena. I don't even know that one. You Can't See Me? I think that used to be a Ghostface song. What's up?
It'd be Stone Cold theme song.
Dude, all the fucking wrestlers theme song. How about that? Real American, for sure.
Actually, it would be Sting.
Has to be Real American, bro.
It would be Sting, for sure.
All right, then.
That's the most manly fucking song, dog.
Most manly song.
Yeah, put that shit in there.
How about...
Do it, bro. I dare you.
Who's the most manly singer, bro?
Elton John.
Johnny Cash, Mick Jagger, or Barry White?
Liberace.
Close.
Ted Nugent.
Ted Nugent's pretty dope. I'll take that as an answer. What's the best clothing or best apparel for a man? A suit?
Nothing.
Flannel?
Nothing.
Or wife beater?
Just my unit hanging out.
A leaf?
I mean, for protection, yeah.
Okay, that's what's up.
Flannel and bearskin.
What's the most manly car ever, bro? James Bond's Aston Martin DB5?
John Deere tractor.
I don't even want to go on after that one. I was going to say Kit from Knight Rider and the General Lee from Dukes of Hazzard.
Wrong.
But we're going to have to pick that one, dude. John Deere. okay. Hey, what's the most manly movie ever made, bro? Die Hard, Commando, Rambo, or Bloodsport?
I really don't remember if I played in any of those movies.
All the seasons of Walker, Texas Ranger.
That's yeah. Since you fucking did put Chuck Norris to shame and shit, I'm sure you said that because you have pity for his ass. So all right, cool. Who will win in the fight, bro? Stallone, Arnold, or Van Damme? And let's throw in Steven Seagal in there too. Who do you think will win in the fight?
Jesus with a Tommy gun.
Yeah.
All right. We all aced that shit, bro. Let me see. What else? Oh no, man. That's it. You guys are a fucking man, bro. We're all fucking men. We passed that shit.
I am a real American.
Man, I'm just joking, man. All jokes aside, nothing makes a man feel better than a woman. Just fucking around here. So let's get into it. Let's talk about some other shit, man. What's going on in the world today? Let's talk about some current conspiracies.
Want to talk about current conspiracies, bro?
Yeah, man. It's a shame, bro. It's kind of crazy with the last podcast, how we just end it with the psyops talking about shootings and shit. And a few days later, fucking shooting happened and shit. It's fucking crazy, bro.
Yeah, I know. It's terrible.
And to come to find out, there has been shootings. We were wrong about that. There has been. I guess like, there's shit always going on, bro. But
always, dude.
Yeah.
Always.
Okay. What's up?
What are they? They consider a mass shooting like more like three or more people or something that get shot or die?
I don't know, man.
Like three or four or something? It's really not that much.
Yeah.
But obviously.
How many people passed away in the shooting? Was it four or six people? Huh?
I think it was three.
Three?
I think it was three.
I think it was like three kids and three teachers or something like that. I think it was like six of them.
Yeah, it sucks because like the pastor of like one of the kids that got killed.
Yeah.
Her dad was like a pastor at like the one of the churches.
Yeah.
And apparently the girl that went in and shot and killed everybody was like, she like went to the church and knew the pastor and I don't know, I guess maybe had a vendetta against him or something, but she like went specifically to wherever the pastor's daughter like room was and, like hunted her down specifically. So
I don't know, man. It's a shame. And it's like a little, it's a change, huh? It's crazy, bro. Cause now it's a woman or was it a girl or a girl?
It was a female. It was a female that was trying to go,
That's
pretty sure, yeah.
Yeah, that did the shooting, huh? Yeah. Was her name Audrey? Let me see what's up.
Audrey Hill.
Audrey Hill, oh, man.
Yeah, it was a biological female that tried to. Because there's pictures of her, like, I don't know.
Audrey Hale, yeah. Audrey
Two, Hale, three, 4 years ago. Well, no, actually, that's a lie. No, I guess if she's 28 now, there was pictures of her when she was probably like 14 or 15. She looked like a normal teenage girl.
And I heard that her mom or somebody in her family, I think it was her mom. Like holds meetings or I don't know about like, you know, I think she talks about not bringing guns to school, gun safety, all that stuff, right? Against guns, I think the mom is.
Probably. I bet she was probably some kind of advocate for some, you know, group against gun violence or something. But also I had heard that her parents weren't accepting of like her lifestyle of her wanting to be trans and.
Oh, because she wasn't?
All this stuff,
Okay, I didn't know that. Yeah, it's just...
I mean, when you load a woman up on testosterone, can they handle it like a real man?
Is that what happened in this case?
Well, I don't know. She probably was on... She was 28, dude. So she probably, I would assume, had a job, would maybe have some kind of income in order... I mean, she had income to buy a $700 rifle and, like, a few other rifles. So I would have to assume... Maybe she had the money to get hormones, whether it be
I think insurance paying for that, depending where you're at.
Yeah, that too.
Raging hormones and shit?
That too.
I don't know, man. And there's some crazy shit. I don't know if it's true, but they're all talking about, like, her shoes and all that shit. About there was, like, a difference in shoes at the scene. I don't know.
Yeah, but I think we've watched a few things that that seems kind of...
Debunked already?
A little debunked. I mean, there's definitely some plausible explanations.
Yeah.
Muddying the well.
Yeah, that's what's going on. Yeah. I'm sure it's just some...
Muddying the water.
Yeah. That's...
I don't know.
Well poisoning.
It's... I'm not saying this is like a psyop or anything. I'm just saying
that. Yeah, it sucks.
It's just like a tragedy. Definitely a tragedy. And
Yeah, you know, I think it was today... a lot of the left stormed the capital of Tennessee, like busted through and was like in the gallery of like the Senate room, like screaming and yelling and stuff, which is, I mean, honestly, you know,
yeah,
basically what they're, you know, they deemed as, you know, something that you could spend your life in jail for on January 6th.
Yeah.
You know, they literally basically did, you know, almost the same thing. I mean, I don't know how loony people got at the Tennessee one. Mm-hmm. I know a few people got kind of loony.
Yeah.
On January 6th, which those people should be condemned for sure.
Yeah.
But I mean, they forcibly pushed their way into the building.
Yeah.
You know, which is technically a federal building.
Breaking and entering and shit.
Yeah. And then your boy Trump got indicted today.
Shout out.
Yeah. To the big dog, the top G, bro. Yes, top G. Up?
Fucking.
Yeah.
El jefe. El mero mero.
Make America el jefe again.
Shit, man. Damn. What else is going on? You know what? Also, I saw that the scientists have discovered a massive ocean, bro, beneath the Earth's surface. It's bigger than the seas combined, I believe, above land.
You know, that's crazy because we know more about the moon than we do our own oceans. So to find out there's actually more water, like, inside the Earth than there is outside the Earth is crazy.
Yeah, you're right.
I thought it was
supposed to be magma. It's supposed to be like a molten core.
Well, like depending on how deep you get in the surface.
Bro,
but that
you guys are wrong, bro. It's fucking hollow and shit. We all know that.
Like, I wouldn't be surprised if they were completely wrong. I mean,
there's something down there, bro. It's the
land. I think a lot of the scientific theories are just kind of built on like a house of cards, you know? It's just like, it's like a big cult. Like, they don't understand something, so they're going to make the math and different things fit so it can, you know.
Yeah.
Well, that's what they've done with human civilization, pretty much, you know? Anatomical humans, right? So people that are literally just like you and I have the same anatomical qualities, right? We're just as limber and we can do all that stuff. Not only that, we also have the exact same cognitive abilities, okay? The exact same, the way you think is the exact way, and the way you move is the exact way people were moving 300,000 years ago. 300,000 years ago. That's a long ass time to think that, you know, human on average lives, what, 50 to 100 years at most? And there's 300,000 of those? Dude, that's enough time for anything to rise and fall and rise and be completely erased or forgotten about.
It's another reason why you gotta spread your seed, bro. Gotta spread that seed.
You gotta build that legacy, baby.
For sure, bro. Gotta stay away from the soy, man. It's a silent killer. Shit's real, man.
No soy boy here. A lot of people believe that there's like a polar shift coming, and that you know, that the elites know about this, and that's why they're kind of trying to squeeze everything they can out at the last minute.
That doesn't matter, dude. Because if 69 switches, baby, it's still 69. You know what I'm saying?
For sure. And there's a polar shift in my balls.
Fuck, dude. I don't know what you're tripping about. Polar shift.
Yeah.
Go eat a Klondike bar, brother. Polar shift. All right, let's shift into third gear here.
Yeah, let's shift into third gear. What else, man? Let's talk about some more shit, or let's talk about some more manly shit. What should we do? Let's all drink some beers.
You know, I heard a guy, he got tired of something. So what he did is he said, you know what? I'm gonna become a woman. And he entered into this female's like weightlifting competition.
Yeah.
And just...
And won?
Smashed. Smashed the record, dude.
Shit, I never won anything in my life, bro. Maybe I need to do something like
that.
That's
what I'm saying, bro. I mean, didn't that one person do it where they weren't good at one thing, swimming, and they decided to become another person, and they were number one dog?
They bodied that shit?
Bodied it, dude. Damn, bodied bro. It, bro.
I'm telling you, that's the secret to success, bro. Be a man.
I think so, dude.
I don't know, but
need to find an acronym for man.
Man, beep 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 beep. Oh shit, man! Some more breaking news. Andrew Tate and his brother are released from a Romanian jail and placed under house arrest. Oh shit! Damn, dude, party at Andrew's. Shit's crazy out there, guys. Shit's crazy.
It's raining men. Hallelujah.
She's a man eater. Gonna give her that dick. Give her that dick. Let me see. I don't know what else to say, guys. I don't want to be all crude and rude, but I guess we got to wrap this shit up, huh? That's it, man. So any last words before we get out of here, man? It's time to go fucking drop some... Time to go man up and shit.
Alan he already broke character.
Yeah,
he already broke character. We were done already.
Hey, quick question. Macho Man, did you ever sleep with Vince McMahon's daughter?
Many of his daughters. Yeah.
I was going to say maybe his daughter's daughter.
I was like, many men's daughters. I don't know. I can't remember which one his was. Too many. I'm done already.
I'm done too, guys. I gotta go holler. Yeah. I gotta go holler at my third wife. I'm about to wrap it up and shit. Let's wrap it up. Let's say something clever. What's going on? Hold on. We gotta give a message, man. We can't just go out like that. I know we're tired and we're gonna wrap it up pretty soon. Our balls are as we speak, our balls are turning blue.
You're my boy, Blue.
What's the message we want to give out there for all the young men, all the men out there in the world? What's the message we want to give these guys? Keep their head up. You got that dog in
go
you.
Go to bed early. This is a man's world.
This is a man's world. I don't know, dude. I'm too stunned right now.
I'm really high.
Yeah, I couldn't.
High. Yeah, man. Just stay away. Don't be no soy boy. Don't be no fuck boy. Get your balls. Get some sun on your dick and balls. How about that? You need to fucking put some sun on your dick and balls. It's very important. There's science on it now.
So I was telling Danny that men need to start taking their sons to strip clubs again and whorehouses.
Yeah, that's true. For their like 10th birthday.
Get them drunk. I was getting drunk since I was 8 years old. Probably younger.
Or respect.
I ran my own distillery by the time I was 6.
I'm pretty sure I rode my bike 20 miles a day at school.
I invented the bike.
I invented bench pressing.
I invented your mom.
I pressed the bench.
I pressed your mom.
I move the ground when I do push-ups.
The ground moves under me when I do push-ups.
You want to go?
And go right now. You want to go?
Love me.
Without a woman or a girl.